second.
These clothes in.
Treacle and caramel? I'd never mix those ingredients.
No, that's toffee and caramel.
Juliana, the letter, it says the hotel development will commence at the end of the month.
But how can they do that? And what about the tenants in the lane? We have rights, too.
That's a bullying tactic, Juliana. Make it sound inevitable, so no one objects.
It's my latest. Tell me what you think.
Too bitter for my taste.
Perfect for the brokenhearted.
I like coming here. You must fight them, Juliana.
Well, I never liked bullies.
Here you go, boss.
You want to get sent back to the Ford squad car?
Sorry,
thank you.
You're getting a real looker here. Legs up to armpits.
Yeah, we know you like them docile, Toby, but how about a little respect?
I heard you're on a detox, Amara. What'd you do? Flush out your sense of humor.
Why don't you make yourself useful? Get rid of the sticky beaks.
Enjoy it while you can.
If the evil gnome gets that promotion, I'll kill myself.
Yeah, let's make a pact.
Okay, so no ID, no mobile, lipstick, condoms, $50.
Girl needs for a night out.
What? You think she's meeting someone?
I'm hoping to.
Well, you know, Riley, if you and me went on a date, I'd drive you home.
She was definitely on the prowl. No knickers.
Ciao, Juliana.
Ciao. You guys all good? Great.
Hello. Would you like to try one?
No, thanks. I'm not a chocolate kind of guy.
You must have misread the sign.
No, I'm detoxing, thank you.
From what?
Oh, life's excesses. Supposed to be doing me good.
I'll take one for later.
Thank you. Detective Sergeant Bennett O'Mara. Do you own this place?
I'm Juliana Levies.
Is this one of yours, Miss Levies?
Is this about the murder?
Yes. Look, this might be a little bit upsetting for you, but do you mind if I show you a picture of the victim? You know her?
No, not really. She came in here a few times. She sat alone. She drank hot chocolate. She never said a word.
Did she come in yesterday?
No.
You don't happen to know her name, do you? Look, if you think of anything or remember anything. Thanks.
There is one thing. This girl, whoever she is, she didn't buy that chocolate here.
You're saying this wrapper doesn't belong to you?
Oh, it's mine, but it's from a special order. There's only one client I sell it to.
Celine Davies.
What you treated her for addiction?
That's my specialty, yes.
And where do the chocolates come from?
Behaviour modification. Certain urges can be overcome with a delaying mechanism, and it's easier to delay with a little sensory substitution.
Chocolates? You must have a lot of fat clients.
Conquering addiction isn't easy. The biggest mistake most people make is thinking they can battle it alone.
And what was Celine battling?
I'm afraid I can't tell you. I'm bound by patient confidentiality, but I'm sure you know that.
Well, Celine's dead. I'm sure she won't mind.
Well, when you present the proper warrant, we'll talk further. Unless you'd like to make an appointment for yourself. Hmm? What is it? Caffeine? Smokes?
Well, can you at least give me Celine Davies' address?
Hey, boss, prelim exam just came through. No sign of sexual interference. Guess we can exclude Ray.
What do you reckon this place is worth?
I don't know. It's more than a cop can afford.
Brand spanking new.
Good view, too.
Be handy to work.
Yeah. What about a bit of soul, cop?
Soul.
Or rock and roll.
What do you reckon she used these for?
I don't know. Maybe she was a dancer.
I don't think dancers made that much.
Maybe somebody was looking after her.
What, like a sugar daddy?
Oh, nobody uses that term, Carl.
Wait, except sugar daddies.
Ministry of Planning, Stuart Burgess' office. How may I help you?
Hi. Look, I'm just wondering, does the name Celine Davies mean anything to you?
No, I'm sorry, it doesn't.
Okay, could I please speak to the minister?
He's not available at the moment. Can I take a message?
Who are you?
I'm more of a bricks and mortar politician. You give me a trowel and a bucket of cement, I'll build you a wall. Give me a tube of paint and a paintbrush, I'm likely to ask for a roller instead. But look, I do know a thing or two about beauty. You only have to look at my lovely wife Marion to realise that. Now, this new Emerson wing is a creation of architectural beauty. I'm very proud of my government's role in helping to fund it. But look, without further prattling on from me, I will, in lieu of a ribbon, declare this wing officially open.
Well, we've got a lot of protesters, as you've probably heard it.
No, look, I've got, this government has very big plans for the city.
Got one of hers at home. Bought it before she got big. Lucky me, eh? You by yourself?
Yes.
Rent magazine, art galleries are the best places to meet people when you're over a certain age. Free food, booze.
No entry fee.
And if you don't hit it off, easy to move on to the next prospect.
Exactly. Excuse me.
You don't intend to let the grass grow underneath our feet. Not what we've concreted anyway. So I am all for open green spaces. I think there are a few eyesores in this city that need bulldozing, though.
Charlton Lane's no eyesore.
Charlton Lane.
Where you're trying to evict people to build a lousy hotel?
Ah, that would be the lousy hotel with the 7-star international rating.
What about the people who live and work in the lane? The people who have businesses there?
Well, now, look, I can assure you that our government will be doing everything we can to help those people relocate.
How about I come and knock your home down, Mr. Berger? You to relocate.
Well, good luck. It's heritage listed.
A few dollars in the right minister's pocket would solve that problem, wouldn't it? Isn't that how it works?
Ma'am, do you have an invitation?
Well, this is a public gallery.
At a private function.
Excuse me.
Come with me, please.
Could you take your hands
right
off,
this
please?
Way.
That's nice.
Excuse me. Trouble? I'm not your concern,
mate. I'll deal with this.
Are you following me, Detective?
Are you following me, Miss Louise? What's up with you and Virgil?
Just a misunderstanding. If you're not following me, what are you doing here? This doesn't strike me as your kind of scene.
Really? Why do you say that?
Well, Nanny doesn't like chocolate.
Well, there's no appreciation for art. I'm here to see the minister.
I hope you have better luck than I do. Goodbye, Detective.
Several.
Celine Davies, do you know the name?
No, should I?
Well, she recently telephoned your office.
Well, thousands of people call my office.
Yes. Well, this particular caller was found murdered this morning. Strangled to death.
Sorry, that's terrible.
Your office was the last call that she made from her landline.
And as I said, my department's telephone never stops ringing. You know, endless inquiries, questions, complaints. You know, we even get the occasional wrong number.
She was also the face of your campaign, Charlton Towers.
Look, Detective, I think you're drawing a long bow. No, I'm not the developer. I don't know anything about that side of things. But look, if you excuse me, I've got a bit more schmoozing to do. But good luck with your investigation.
She wanted to tell someone, and I just happened to be there.
What, in the bathroom?
Coffee, mate.
I'd love one, but no, thanks, mate.
He's detoxing.
And, what, did she tell you who he was having the affair with?
She doesn't know, but does it matter?
My wife was having an affair, I'd want to know who with.
The who isn't important. It's all about the why. Like, why are you detoxing?
I told you why.
Life's excesses.
Yeah. But that's not a good enough reason for it.
Detox is deprivation by another name. Why do you feel the need to deprive yourself?
Are you married?
No. Why?
Never.
I think I'll go. He was definitely following me. I mean, he said he wasn't, but he kept asking me questions.
He's a cop. That's what they do.
Ow. What does my marital status have to do with it?
Yeah, I see that.
More or less.
What'd you say?
I didn't answer.
Guy asks if you're married and you don't answer him. Might as well say you're up for it.
He's not that attractive.
So if he was attractive, you'd let him handcuff you?
Shut up.
It's not this. You can do this the easy way. Or the hard way.
Definitely the hard way.
Oh, and I spoke to the guys at Jacob.
And what did the developer say?
The builder's PR company hired Celine through a modelling agency.
And a garbage sec like you would turn his nose up at this.
It's possible I'm not a sore on the billboard. I became obsessed with her.
Yeah, well, anything's possible, Carl. Hey, I'll see you at Finch's at 8:30 in the morning, okay?
Bye, boss.
Hello. Bye. Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, it's up, Roman.
Roman. Oh, okay. How many junk food ads there are on TV?
I don't watch TV, Dad. I've got better things to do.
Oh, yeah, me too.
It's Mum's birthday in a couple of days. Will you be there?
I'm not sure, Luz. I'm pretty swamped with work.
You're always finding excuses.
Oh, shit.
What?
Hang on, Luz. I'll call you back.
Yeah.
Hey, Roman. Roman. Hey, come on. Out, mate, out. Up. Come on. Oh.
Sorry, it's Bennett, Detective O'Mara. The chocolate I took from the shop.
Why?
Well, my dog ate it, and now he's sick.
Your dog? What kind of an idiot gives chocolate to a dog?
Could you just tell me what was in the chocolate, please?
It's not a dietary condition.
But
it's got nothing to do with anything you ingested.
Vanilla beans?
Hang on a tick.
I'd say it's viral, but I'm more concerned with what I'm feeling. Does Roman have trouble moving around?
Yeah, sure. He's a lazy sort.
Could be an issue with his bones. Not uncommon to breathe. We'll get some x-rays. And pet insurance?
I figured it wasn't the chocolate. I'm sorry for bothering you.
Don't suppose you want half a chocolate croissant?
Sex addiction.
Here's a recording of all our sessions, about 30 hours of it.
So what, she'd just do it any time, any place, with any bloke?
Well, it's a bit more complicated than that, but essentially Celine had a homosexual disorder, yes.
Oh, I just thought that was rubbish. Just the excuse for all those horny celebrities rooting around.
Oh, it's a real addiction, trust me, and not a very pleasant one.
So when you gave Celine this particular chocolate, what is part of a therapy?
No, I don't use chocolate replacement with sex addicts, chocolate being an aphrodisiac.
So what, Celine just snuck this from your office then?
No, impossible, I keep the chocolates locked up. They're bloody expensive.
So which clients do you give this particular chocolate to, Doctor?
Sex angle gives us motive. One of the boyfriends finds out she's spreading the love.
All it gives us is a long list of suspects. Take at least another day for a new warrant.
Celine and I are neighbours. We were neighbours. We had a lot in common. Dance clubs, music. We're both into vinyl. And we were FWBs.
Friends with benefits.
How was it you were both seeing Dr. Finch?
Celine recommended him to me. I'm mildly agoraphobic.
I thought Finch was a specialist in addictions.
Oh, I'm addicted to the internet, yeah. Sorry.
Oh, what, because you stay inside?
Yeah, sometimes go days without seeing anyone.
Apart from Celine?
She was hot for me. We'd do it all the time. In the lift, stairwell, sometimes at the park.
In the open?
That good therapy.
Yeah, for you, maybe. She was a sex addict. Why did you break into Celine's flat?
I lent her a coffee grinder. A good one. They're hard to replace. I asked for it back 100 times and she just kept fobbing me off. I'd run out of patience.
Where were you there before last, between 8 p.m. and midnight?
I was beheading trolls. An online fantasy game.
Can anyone verify that?
Only about a zillion people.
Chili and cinnamon.
Mm. It's hot. And sweet. It tastes kind of sticks to your tongue.
It's meant to.
Oh, well, in that case, it's perfect. Sorry. I need some water.
Oh, Marion, you found us.
Yes, hello. I just wanted to thank you for yesterday. Oh, and do you have any more of those chocolates? They did, in fact, give me a lift.
Here we are. No, these are a gift.
Oh, thank you. I think I can help you in return. I understand you've been trying to get an appointment with my husband.
I can't get past his PA. Apparently, I'm on his blacklist.
Oh, well, why don't you come to our house tonight, say 8 o'clock? I will make sure Stuart's available. The rest is up to you.
Thank you. Marion, you don't need my chocolates for a lift. If you really are unhappy, you should do something about it.
I intend to.
You think a snake like Virg is gonna change his mind just because wifey asked him to? All you need is some dirt on the dude.
I'll get the computer crime boys to match his username and password to his IP, see if he was logged on.
I have no idea what that means, but yeah, do that.
Notes from the post-mortem, Celine was 3 months pregnant. Find the father, find the killer.
Fetal DNA might help if we've got a suspect.
Awesome.
You are here to file a complaint? Unsolicited and abusive phone calls in the middle of the night?
No, but it was unsolicited and mildly abusive.
I'm sorry about that.
A group of us are going to karaoke on Friday night if you want to come.
I do. A wicked Robbie Williams.
Yeah, but you do.
So we're
fine. How's your dog?
Expensive. Turns out he's got hip dysplasia and needs a knee reconstruction. $5,000 later.
Ouch. Won't fix his knee, but might be better for his teeth than chocolate. Raw chicken wings.
Chicken wings? Well, you came down here to give me chicken wings for my dog. Okay, on behalf of Roman, thank you.
I'm detective. I wasn't entirely truthful yesterday about my misunderstanding with Stuart Berger at the gallery. Truth is, he has approved a redevelopment for Charlton Lane. He's kicking me out of my shop.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Well, of course, that has nothing to do with you, but you said you were there to talk to him?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not surprised he's done something illegal.
Miss Louise.
Juliana.
Do you want me to dish dirt on a state minister?
Just dirt?
Not that I've found.
Maybe you need to dig deeper.
Thanks for the advice. Excuse me. Frank Cogitano, about time you called me back.
What's up, mate?
Hey, Roman, that dog that you sold me.
Yeah, how is Roman?
Yeah, not good, mate. He needs an operation, a rather expensive operation, $5,000. And that's $5,000 I don't have.
Nah, forget that. I've got some stuff that'll fix him.
What stuff? Inject this into his hip and knee.
What is it?
It's a protein mix with a healing agent. 2 shots a day, 1.5 mils, dissolved in water. You don't look so flush there, Benny. A bit pale around the gills, mate.
I'm 3 weeks into a detox, mate.
Forget that. Here. Try this instead.
No, I don't think so.
It's totally legit. Acai berry and some other herbal shit. That's a sample. If you want more, you know my number.
Yeah. Thanks, Frank. Hey, stay out of trouble, yeah?
See you, mate.
Station one, Celine Davies.
I'm not sure why I do it, but sometimes the more public the place, the better. The elevators, taxi rides, once on a train.
Roman,
we were talking.
Keep still, mate.
You asked me last week if I had a preferred type. I like lonely men. Just happens most lonely men are married. You get married, say you've got someone to love, have sex with whenever you want. But most married couples I know hardly ever do it, and none of them are still in love with each other.
This is going to hurt me more than you ever.
Hey, Carl, come in.
Still no sign of Celine's mobile. There's nothing in her call charge records. Riley's checking with her phone carrier.
Hey, could you do us a favour? Hang on to it.
Hey?
Roman, Carl, Roman.
G'day, Roman. Having trouble locating Celine's next of kin, too. Her parents are both dead. No siblings.
Just keep him still, make sure he doesn't move.
And her bank accounts are pretty empty. I mean, there's nothing from that modelling job. Maybe she's paid cash. Shit.
There you go.
I don't know, you're married?
Not anymore. And what about all the fancy gear in Celine's flat?
Bought a few weeks ago on a 12-month interest-free loan.
What does that tell you?
Well, obviously no sugar daddy. And maybe she had no concern for tomorrow.
Or she's expecting a big windfall.
Yep, the detox boss.
No.
Is it a rod from that one?
Yeah.
Oh. That was so good. Hot. Do you mind if I take the rest with me?
Hello? Mrs. Verger? Marion? Mr. Verger? It's Juliana Lavis.
Oh, boss. Single shot to the chest. No sign of gun, no sign of forced entry. Neighbors have heard nothing.
Running the show.
Who found the body?
All right, enough of the bullshit, Miss Lavis. You didn't just come here tonight so the minister would listen to your zoning complaints, did you? You just admitted you threatened him at the art gallery.
I didn't threaten him.
You said you were going to burn his house down.
I said I was going to knock his house down. I was trying to make a point.
Hey, Toe,
If she was planning to kill the minister, don't you think she'd be a little more discreet than threatening him in public?
Motive, no alibi. What are you doing here anyway? I got the call out, this job's mine.
No, none of it's got to do with Celine Davies, that's my job.
What's it got to do with her?
Well, this was found in the study. Same chocolate was found with Celine Davies.
Well, maybe she knocked her off too. She was a customer, wasn't she? She ever proposition you?
What?
You know? Hit on you for some girl-on-girl action.
Hey, Toby. Toby, leave now. You all right?
Not really. I'm feeling a bit sick.
This is my house. Let me through, please.
Stop. Can't. Can't let her in.
Where's my house?
With Stuart.
With Stuart.
There's Sturger.
Sturger, please.
Oh, my God.
Cited Mrs. Verger to murder.
No, but I told her that leaving a cheating husband wasn't the worst thing in the world.
What makes you think she'd listen to you?
2 years ago, my then husband had an affair. I knew how Marion was feeling.
Well, when you found out, did you want to kill your husband?
Sure. Mostly I wanted to kill the other woman.
Will his office have a record of it?
His wife organized it. You think I'm a suspect, too?
Oh, it doesn't matter what I think, but your chocolates keep turning up at crime scenes. Some people might start to get the wrong idea.
I'll get onto it.
Mm-hmm. Did you check with the phone's carrier?
Zip. No texts of any real interest in the last 30 days.
Yeah, what about voicemail?
They're trying.
It was funny.
You? Putting yourself through hell?
3 weeks down, one to go.
And then what?
I celebrate with a bottle of red.
And someone special? It's my birthday in a week. Maybe we could celebrate together.
Haven't you got a boyfriend?
I haven't got anyone.
Hey, you're looking a bit tired there, mate. Something keep you up all night. Yeah. I heard you, drove the prime suspect home. What'd you do? Go in for a cup of hot chocolate, did you?
You're a dickhead, Toby.
What's that? That's me going right over your head. I can't wait to tell the super about your little breaches of protocol. Actually, I might do that right now. Toby?
Sharon here. The boss wants to see you.
What, now?
Yeah, he says it's important.
Oh, what do you know? I was the boss's PA wanting to talk to me about something important. And my first act when I take over this crew? It'll be to dump your ass off this case.
Thanks for that.
You owe me that drink now.
Maybe Toby's on to something. Her chocolate. I mean, you always say wherever there's smoke, they're probably in it up to their necks.
I wouldn't mix my metaphors like that.
Miss Lavise, what a surprise. You don't normally hand deliver. Thank you. Come in. So, what do I owe this personal treatment?
Stuart Verger, the State Minister. He was murdered last night.
Yes, I heard it on the news.
Verger was a client of yours, wasn't he?
I can't discuss that.
Was Celine Davies and Stuart Verger having an affair? Was she trying to expose him? Was she blackmailing him?
I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
No, please, you have to help me.
No, I don't.
No, you don't understand. The police suspect me of being involved.
It's got nothing to do with me.
Hasn't it?
Are you accusing me of something?
I don't know.
Get the hell out of my office. Get out!
Following you.
Are you here to see Finch?
Yes, I am. I might be here to get his DNA.
You think Finch is involved?
Yeah, there's a lot of paths crossing at his door. Your chocolates in Verger's study could only have come from Finch's office, right? Yeah. I presume that's why you're here. All right, you're one of Finch's clients as well?
No, I'm here to find some answers. I figure the best way to prove my innocence is to help you do your job.
Oh, and what makes you think that I need help?
Well, you obviously think I'm involved.
Are you?
And now you're playing mind games.
Oh, says the woman who tried to buy me with chicken wings.
They were for your dog. Don't tell me you ate them.
I better go and execute this. So, Celine was seeing Finch for sex addiction. Verger was seeing him for an addiction to porn.
Sounds like a marriage made in heaven.
Now, according to Finch, Celine seduced Verger. Berger pulled a few strings with his construction mates and got Celine this gig here. Now, their affair carried on for over 3 months, and Verger was keen to win.
No, but she was trying to blackmail him over the pregnancy.
Yeah, well, we'll know more once Verger's DNA's tested against the fetus.
Okay, so Verger kills Celine to shut her up. But who kills Verger?
Little Miss Chocolate Shop. She had motive, she had opportunity. She found at the scene.
Yeah, she reported the scene.
Yeah, to cover her tracks. Explain her fingerprints all over the place.
No, I don't think she did it. These murders have to be connected.
I agree.
Okay, so why would Juliana kill Celine?
Well, maybe Juliana knew that Celine was doing the minister as she wanted to make him suffer.
Why don't you try thinking with your head for a change, Toby? That'd help.
At least I don't think with my dick, Amara.
Yeah? Why don't you just sit down?
Hey, come on, fellas. Come on.
Yeah, I know that bogus phone call from the boss was your doing. I know that was you.
I've just got back from computer crime. They've cracked Celine's phone.
Celine Davies.
What are you talking about?
You said you didn't know who your husband was having an affair with, but Celine's phone log proves that you did. In fact, you made a number of calls to her.
My husband never wanted children. That woman took great pleasure in telling me that she was pregnant.
Did you kill Celine Davies?
Not Celine, no.
Look at this.
In breaking news, Marion Verger, wife of recently deceased State Minister for Planning, Stuart Verger, has been arrested and charged with his murder.
Police aren't releasing details, but sources say Mrs. Verger was distressed by the recent revelation of an affair by Mr. Verger.
Are you going to plead guilty, Mrs. Verger?
She was taken away for further questioning, but it will be alleged she shot her husband Wednesday evening.
I know why you're here. That poor woman.
No, I wouldn't be too upset. She used you as a scapegoat. Set up the meeting with her husband, knowing he'd find the body and be blamed for it.
Hey, what's up?
This is Detective Sergeant O'Mara, Saxon Blake.
You're the cop that was following Juliana.
No, he wasn't following me. Thank you, Detective, for the update. Mrs. Verger killed her husband.
Oh. You're off the hook, then.
Look, I just need to cover something off. Mrs. Verger was with her husband at a function the night that Celine was murdered. You were here on your own that night, were you?
No, I was here with her.
Oh, excuse me. Hey, Lucy.
It's Mum's birthday today.
Yeah, no, I'm right in the middle of a murder investigation at the moment.
Dad, you said you'd be there.
I thought you were working.
I'm working. I'm taking Bunny for a run in a lunch hour.
Really?
Yeah, she wants to lose half a kilo.
Well, I can't promise anything, but I'll try, okay?
Dad, I'll be there at 5 o'clock.
Okay, 5 o'clock.
Be there, please.
Okay, bye.
She never said anything.
You're right.
Sorry about that. Well, I should go, I suppose. Hey, good to meet you, Sexton.
I'm gonna grab Bunny.
Bunny!
Riley just sent this through. Crime scenes inventory of Celine Davies flat.
It's, What do you think, Riley, boss?
Hmm?
Do you reckon she fancies?
No, I'm too old for him.
No, not you. As if. No, do you think she fancies me?
How would I know?
Well, you're supposed to be observant.
Well, I'm good with facts, Carl. Details. People just completely confuse me. Hang on a sec.
Well, what is it?
Get in the car.
You want to tell me what you're looking for?
Yeah, inventory list. There's no mention of a coffee grinder, so must be here. Hey, tell me what you see.
moldy tomato. Doesn't look like she ate at home much.
No coffee beans. I'm in the fridge, not the pantry.
So, no coffee beans. What does she need a grinder for?
Yeah, well, if Travis has lied about that, what else did he lie about being her FB or a FW or whatever it is?
Yeah, but he knew about her vinyl collection.
What was Travis's addiction?
The internet. Why, what are you thinking?
Well, give an agoraphobic internet addict access into Celine's world.
She wouldn't touch.
Boss. I run that down to the car.
Just Toby. Get him out of here. He was stalking.
Come on. Up. Perf. There's about 500 hours of footage. It's going to take days to trawl through it all.
Oh, was this a week ago?
Celine?
Oh, there's Celine.
Well, who's that then?
Look, we need to get this stuff to HQ, analyze it properly.
Carl, you can help Riley out. I need to lock yourselves away for a few days.
Sure thing, boss.
Okay, and I want to find out who that is in the video.
Come on.
Look, I'm going to read out a number to you. Just let me know if the number means anything. You right?
2098.
Sounds like a postcode.
Oh.
Yeah, what?
Could be an order number for my chocolates. A recent order by the sound of it. Here it is.
What's this about? Why are you checking on the chocolate order?
Can you just give me the details?
It was a telephone order paid by Visa last week by...
Celine Davies. This order was taken by Bunny. It's in her illegible scroll.
Okay, what was the order? Where did it go?
Vanilla and Gandia truffles to a Mr. Charles Peterson, 35 Smith Street, Rose Bay. What's this about, Detective?
I'm sorry to bother you, but I need to talk to you.
He can't hear you. He's in a coma. Has been for the last 4 days, according to the nurse. He's not going to wake up.
I'm sorry, why are you here?
It's my chocolates that are the link, not me.
Vanilla and...
Grenadier. It's a fruit.
You seem to be enjoying them.
I'm sorry, but you shouldn't be here. Rules are family only.
How long is he gone?
We thought he had 6 months, but after the last few days, it could be any time.
Have you got any family?
His niece, Celine. Celine Davies?
I don't know her surname. Pretty blonde girl. I'm sure she's the only visitor Mr. Peterson's had.
It must cost a packet to stay in a place like this.
Mr. Peterson can afford it.
And he fell into a coma 4 days ago?
Yes.
It explains a big buying spree anyway. Celine. She's obviously anticipating an inheritance.
You think she was murdered over money?
Well, money's a motive I can understand.
As opposed to passion?
Well, crimes of passion sounds good in a movie trailer.
What about Mrs. Verger?
Revenge. Her perfect world was about to come crumbling down all due to her husband not being able to keep it in his pants.
She loved him.
There's one big soft center. Oh, damn. Sorry, quick detour. I hope you don't mind. Hey, I won't be too long. Or, I can call you a cab if you'd like.
No, no, it's okay. Bonnie's got the shop.
For long blues.
God, give me that. It was a lame excuse then, it still is. How do you think she felt, not having you there? Especially at the end. Don't know why I bother, Mom.
Hey, Lucy. Luce?
Your time with him.
No, I'm just...
He'll let you down in the end. He has no feelings.
Sorry about that. She blames me for not being there for another.
Makes people say things they don't mean.
No, she means it all right. She's right. I'm a coward.
There's a
hey, Carl, take this chocolate down to forensics. I want it analyzed.
For what?
I'm not sure. That's why I want to have it checked.
We've got a problem. The video files on Travis's hard drive, they're gone.
What do you mean they're gone?
Well, it could be Travis planted a virus as a safeguard, you know, in case someone like us tried to look at it.
Did you manage to identify the person in that video?
No, not yet. But the computer crime boys are looking at it now, so if anyone can salvage it, it's them.
Yeah, what about Travis?
Oh, hi, mate.
Celine Davies.
What?
A telephone order last week.
God, I honestly don't remember.
Vanilla and grenadier. It's an unusual combination. I'm surprised it didn't stick out.
No, that's not vanilla and grenadier. That's vanilla and Grand Marnier. Is it Grand Marnier? No, my own handwriting.
Unfortunately, you're the only one who does. I made vanilla and grenadier.
Oh. I won't tell if you won't. See ya.
Ryman. Come on, mate. Hello?
Do you like fish and chips?
No, thanks. I've held out this long.
I used to love the sound of the ocean.
Used to?
Tell me about your wife. Your daughter's right. You're a closed book.
She called me a closed book? Well, tell me about your ex-husband. This is about sharing personal information. You first.
He was, is a banker.
Oh, I hate him already.
We were married for 8 years, moved here after 3. We bought a beach house in Scarborough. And he would sometimes go down there alone and at weekends to work on financial proposals.
Oh, sounds almost boring enough to be true.
One weekend I decided to surprise him. It was our anniversary, which typically did not. There was a box of my chocolates on the table with someone missing. Richard didn't like dark chocolate. It was then that I knew. He got the dog and most of the money, and I got the beach house.
Beach house in Scarborough doesn't sound like a bad deal.
Well, it's more of a shack. I haven't been back there since.
So what? You spied on him and caught him in the act?
Maybe I had an inkling.
I don't think it had more than inkling. Probably, forgotten anniversaries, lonely nights on your own. You obviously wanted to catch him out so you could understand why your sex life had dropped off. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. I'm sorry. Juliana.
Your turn.
Okay. Okay, Lainey. One morning she got out of the shower and said that she had a lump. I tried to pretend it wasn't happening, so I just put my head down, bum up, and got on with work, and I was working when she died. Lucy's never forgiven me. Excuse me. This better be good news.
Some. We've salvaged a couple of hours of Travis's footage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, is there anything on it?
Oh, visions of her arguing with some dude in her flat. I don't think it's the same person we saw earlier, but it looks heated.
Okay, we'll send it through to the firm. Excuse me.
Obsessed with me. Women often mistake me taking a professional interest in their bodies as an interest in them.
You must get a lot of sexual offers.
And I knock them all back.
Apart from Celine.
She was persistent.
She was a sex addict.
I did not know that at the time.
Well, when you found out Celine was murdered, why didn't you say anything?
I don't know. I guess I was concerned with how it might look.
It looks pretty heated. What were you arguing about? Her exercise routine?
I told Celine that I'd met someone that really mattered to me and that I wanted to end it with her. She didn't like that idea. She accused me of using her for sex. Pot kettle or what?
Then what happened?
Nothing. She got the message.
Oh, so a woman who was totally obsessed with sex gave you up just like that?
Yeah, I made it pretty clear that I was in love with Juliana.
Tell me about your relationship with Juliana.
Been together 6 months.
Any plans for the future?
What's that got to do with you?
Well, you say you're in love with Juliana.
No, is Juliana in love with you?
I don't know. You better ask her that.
No, I'm asking you, Saxon. Planning on getting married?
No.
I'm planning on asking her.
I don't know. Maybe. Why?
Did you tell Juliana about Celine?
What do you reckon?
Well, she's a pretty
perceptive woman, wouldn't you say? She doesn't miss very much.
And frankly, Saxon, you don't strike me as a master of deception.
particularly when it comes to women.
Interview with Saxon Blake suspended at 9:48 a.m.
Make yourself scarce.
What am I doing here? You trying to humiliate me?
Did you know he was having an affair with Celine?
No.
You said that Celine came to your shop maybe to check out the competition, maybe to confront you.
Well, she didn't say anything. What are you getting at?
Motive. Jealousy. Celine tells you about her and Saxon and...
Why would I kill someone just because they were having sex?
Was that all he meant to you? When you found out your husband was having an affair, you said you wanted to kill the other woman.
You bastard. Boss, DNA tests have come back.
Maybe Toby's right. All paths do lead to you. Did you kill Celine Davies?
Excuse me.
What's she doing here? Where's her boyfriend?
In the room.
Was I talking to you?
Oh, back off, Toby. You're impeding my investigation.
Oh, no, this is my investigation. Yeah. I just made DSS. Super has put me in charge of the crew. Now, these nice boys here are police integrity, and they want to have a word with you. Seems you've been surveilled doing a little deal with Frank Cogitano. Selling information for drugs would be my bet.
That's my dog, you idiot.
You're a bent bastard.
And you're an evil little gnome.
Oh!
Right,
mate? Give me a hand.
I'm fine.
DNA match from
Celine Davies'
pictures.
Be
back in a minute,
fellas. Where's he going? What's in that report? Finally. Radio basement over here. Keep an eye on the door.
Suicide.
No shit. Get forensics. Is that a note?
A confession by the looks of it.
She goes to him for sex addiction. His cure is to seduce her.
DNA confirmed Celine's baby was his, so...
So he knocks her off and he shoots himself. That makes sense. But how good's this, Amara? I've been boss half a day. Already solved 2 murders. You better run, mate. You got some house guests waiting.
Hey, careful, that was a wedding present.
What do we got here?
Huh. Loyal fool.
So it's looking bad for you, huh?
Yeah, apparently hanging out with lowlifes like you isn't the smartest career move.
Not doing yourself any favours either. Put this way to harden your arteries.
Yeah, what happened to the detox?
Leave him alone. He's a man after my own heart. Now, here is to hell, which is what it's going to be like with Toby in charge.
Yeah. Jesus. Cheers.
Seriously, Bennett, you've got to clear your name and come back, or I'm transferring to fraud.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, if only my dog could talk.
That's forensics. It's that chocolate you asked me to get analysed.
What chocolate?
Oh, long story. Celine's uncle, Rich, recently deceased.
Got a call from the hospice. He passed away last night.
Yeah, with a little help by the looks of it. There's traces of strychnine in the soft center.
So, what are you saying? Selim killed her uncle. Why?
Obviously, living beyond her means. Maybe she couldn't wait any longer for the inheritance. But Selim didn't order the chocolate. Did computer crime retrieve all of Travis's videos?
Not yet. That was like priority with the case being closed.
Okay, get him on the phone now, will you? And order an autopsy before Celine's uncle's cremated. And we'll need to get off Juliana's order book. We'll need that as evidence.
What evidence of what?
Well, whoever was in that video ordered the chocolates.
It was mercifully quick in the end. Maybe he sensed his niece wasn't coming anymore.
Look, I need the rest of the chocolates that were here.
Oh, they must have been thrown out. They went with this morning's garbage. When I was packing up his things today, I found this. It's a letter from his lawyers.
For this, Celine isn't Peterson's only living relative. Peterson's youngest sister had a baby in 87 when she was 16. Fostered it out to a Tate family from the Fortitude Valley. The baby's name was Robin Peterson. This Robin is about to inherit a very large estate.
Yeah, but if Finch didn't kill Celine, why would he commit suicide?
Carl,
he didn't commit suicide.
Lawyers aren't going to tell us much without a warrant. This is a job for you, Carl.
Well, what do you want me to tell Toby?
Might solve a murder before Toby even knows there was one.
Yep, I reckon that should impress Riley.
And face it, Carl, Riley's just not that into you.
Well, but you said you didn't know about that stuff.
I lied. Hello, this is Detective Ben and O'Mara from New South Wales Police Department. I'm just calling about your foster daughter.
No, I don't have a foster daughter.
You don't have one? What about foster son?
No, I don't have a foster
daughter. Okay, sorry for bothering. Bye.
Hello,
this is Detective Ben and O'Mara from New South Wales Police Department. I'm just calling about your foster daughter. Hello, this is Detective Ben and O'Mara from New South Wales Police Department. Hello, this is Detective Ben and O'Mara from New South Wales Police Department. This stomach is a bottomless pit. Hello.
Hi, you rang before about the baby?
Yep.
For the weekend.
Who are you?
Who are you? Ah, Mr. Fancy Pants Detective.
Please, do you know where Juliana is?
I'm not at liberty to say, Detective.
This is important.
She's at her beach house in Scarborough. I lent her my car, but I don't know the address. You know, Detective, you're not the only person who's been here looking for her.
Soaked out here.